Oil once traded below $0. How can something be worth less than nothing?
Hey everyone, and welcome to this video. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can create this animation inside of Adobe After Effects. So if you are struggling to create gradient designs along with backgrounds for your projects, I think this video will be best for you. Everything is simple and everyone can follow it. Now I want to take a moment to talk about my Patreon page. I share YouTube project files along with trendy animations that I create for my projects. These ready-to-use templates will save you time and are easy to apply to your own work. The club is limited to only 100 people, so join before it's too late. Alright, here we are inside of Adobe After Effects, and now let's begin. So here in Assets panel, I have the reference folder that is made by ChatGPT. And we want to extend this design and make an animation out of this reference. So on the first step, what I want to do is that I want to create a background and I modify it in my own version. Well, to do that, I'm just going to hide the reference for a while. I'm going to create a new solid layer. Let's call it background. And in effects and preset tab, I'm going to just drag the four color gradient and I'm going to apply it to the background. Now let's just set dark colors for these four colors. Now this looks good. Now on the next step, I want to create sort of a light arrays for this background. Well, to do that, I'm going to select the rectangle tool. The color doesn't matter, and I'm going to drag a rectangle like this. All right, let's just call it the light arrays. And on the first step, I'm going to add the fractal noise effect into the light arrays. And I'm going to increase the contrast. Let's say all the way to here. And let's just decrease the brightness to something like this. And I'm going to animate it by holding Alt and then clicking on Evolution. I'm going to write an expression time multiply by 50. And then we have an animation like this. All right. Now on the next step, I'm going to add the CC light burst 2.5 into the light arrays. And then I'm going to increase the intensity. And then let's just increase the light length to 200. That should be good. And let's just decrease the intensity to 90. That looks good. However, we need to fix the duration of the lights. So I'm going to place it in here. It's a bit too much. So I'm going to set it on 50%. All right, that looks good. Now to make it better, what I'm going to do is that I'm going to add the Flexbox blur effect into the light arrays. And then by increasing the blur, we will have a nice looking light arrays like this. So let's preview it. All right, as you see, it looks good. Now, in order to colorize it, all you need to do is that you need to add the tint effect into the light arrays. Now I'm going to change the whites into black and then the blacks into the colors that I like. So right now I'm just going to leave it on purple and that looks good. All right, here's the background design. Now let's get to the designing the elements. Let's reveal these reference and I'm going to design this circle in here. Well, to do that, I'm going to select the circle tool. Let's go into the radial gradient. With that selected, I'm going to set the first point into a bit black color and this one into here. That looks good. Let's draw a circle like this. All right. And then let's go towards the selection tool. Dragging this handle, I'm going to set it like this. All right. This is going to be the base. Now in asset panel, I'm going to bring the drop icon and I'm gonna increase it like this. And let's make sure it's aligned on the middle by bringing the align panel in here. All right. And then I'm gonna just center the base in it as well. All right, this looks good. Let's just parent it to the base and then we move the shape towards here. And now on the next step, what I'm going to do is that I'm just gonna pre-compose it and I'm gonna call it the oil And let's open the oil, and I'm gonna draw a region of interest around it, and then I'm gonna crop it. So this will make the render faster, and also when you're working in the main pre-composition, it won't, you know, select the layer by accident. So I'm just going to select crop comp to region of interest, and we have this shape, which is good. Now let's stylize it even further. Well, to do that, what I'm going to do is that I'm just going to select the ellipse tool one more time. Let's just turn the color from gradient to a solid, and let's just choose a brighter blue color, and I'm going to draw a circle like this, and let's just call it the shape. And I'm going to use the track mat, and I'm going to track mat it to the base layer, and we will have something like this. All right, this seems like good. And then I'm going to apply the fastbox blur effect into the shade layer, and I'm going to increase the blur radius to, let's say, 50. And then on the last step, what I'm going to do is that I'm just going to change the mode from normal to classic color dodge. And there we go. We have a nice shading color that now we can tweak and choose a better color for it. Okay. This looks good. Now, this step is mandatory, but if you have the Deep Glow plugin, you can just create a new adjustment layer, and then you can apply the Deep Glow effect. I'm going to apply the Deep Glow 2 effect, and I'm going to set the exposure to 0.1, and then in input section, I'm going to increase the threshold to, let's say, 94. Let's just turn down the radius to 500 as well. So this will give us a really good glow effect for the animation. But by accident, if you do not have the deep glow effect, you can add the manual glow effect. However, it won't give you a good result as much as the deep glow effect does. All you need to do is that you need to reduce the glow intensity a bit, and then you need to increase the glow intensity. So this will also give something similar to what the deep glow effect does. Now I'm going to enable the deep glow 2 effect, and let's get back to the main composition. Here, I'm just going to set it in here. And as you see, we have some issues with the border of this composition. Well, to fix that, we need to increase the oil comp a bit further. So I'm just going to drag and drop to something like this. And then all you need to do is that you need to select the adjustment layer, and then you can press Ctrl plus Alt plus F to fit it on the composition. Now this issue should be fixed, as you see. And now let's just design these lines in here, which is pretty simple. I'm going to go towards the pen tool. Let's just select the pen tool. Let's give it a stroke. I think 2 pixels should be good. And then I'm going to quickly draw it like the reference. All right, this looks good. Now what we need to do is that we need to bring the floor, and I'm going to do it by simply bringing the floor asset in here, and we don't need this reference anymore, so let's just delete it, and let's just adjust the rest of the layers. Great, now we can just adjust the floor a bit. So to do that, I'm gonna draw a new circle tool, like what we did in the previous section. We're gonna just apply the fastbox blur effect again, increasing the blurriness. Let's just set it in here, and we call it the shade again. And using the track mat, we're gonna just parent it to the floor. And then we're going to just change its mode to classic color dodge. And I'm going to just set it in here. Now you can just choose different colors to make this style a bit better. All right, this seems good. Now it is time to animate the number. Well, to do that, I'm gonna go towards the text tool. I'm gonna just write the 70, and then let's just change the font to Open Sans. I think it looks better. Great. Now, in order to animate it, you can just open the Adobe Bridge in the browse presets, and then you can go towards the text number counters, and you can just select the currency counters. But I personally like to use the number plus one. This is a free plugin that you can download it off the internet, and I'm gonna just set the precisions to 0, and I'm gonna set the end value to 70, and I'm just gonna add these USD dollar sign. So to animate it, all you need to do is that you're gonna just set the start value to 70, and then we have it like this. All right, this looks good. And then what I need to do is that I just need to animate the position value. Let's say when it reaches the 0, it should reaches down like this. Great. And we're gonna just apply the standard easings. Let's go towards the keyframe velocity. I'm just gonna change the influence to 65% for both incoming and outgoing. And then we will have something like this, which is exactly what we want. Great. Now let's just go and animate the camera. So to do that, I'm just gonna select the camera in new, and the type is set on one node, the preset is set on 50mm, which is exactly what we want. And we're gonna create a null object. We're gonna call it the camera controller. And with setting it on 3D, I'm gonna parent everything. And then I'm gonna parent the camera to the camera controller. Now with the layer selected, I'm just gonna set everything except the light rays and background on 3D so we can control it. Now we need to fix the shading a bit. It's in here. Let's just set it on 2D so this will fix the issue. All right, now let's just quickly pre-compose these two layers. Let's just call it the floor, and then we can set it on 3D. So in that way, the shading won't affect when we are moving the camera. And I'm going to press P to reveal the position. And let's just create a subtle zoom out effect. Almost here. F9, and let's just right click on it in keyframe velocity again. I'm gonna set each handles on 65%. Great, that's good, but the camera should never stop in these type of reels. So I'm going to duplicate this camera, parenting it to the second camera, and then I'm gonna just create a subtle zoom out effect like this. Okay, we have it like the reference. Now, in the reference, we had a sudden zoom in effect, so it's pretty simple. I'm gonna just duplicate the camera one more time, creating the keyframes for the position. And again, F9, keyframe velocity, the same step, 65% for each handle. And when it's in here, we're gonna just create a new adjustment layer. And we're gonna just apply the fastbox blur effect one more time. And let's just reveal the third camera controlled keyframe. And we're gonna just quickly increase the blurriness to something like this. And then you can add your own text. So I'm gonna go towards the text tool, and this is the text. and you can change its color to make it more visible or increasing the blurriness a bit. And now to animate the text, I'm just gonna write the slide and pop in, which is in the animate in, it's pre-built text preset in After Effects. And there we go. We have this entire animation. Here we are at the end of this video, and I hope you have enjoyed it. If you have enjoyed this video, don't forget to leave out a like and subscribe to the channel, as it would help me out a lot. Thank you so much for watching this video. I see you in the next one. Goodbye.